I feel very glad and honored to be able to participate such a nice occasion of Gobind's achievements. And when I arrived in Madison in 1963, the first job is to synthesize Deroxy oligonucleotides with repeating sequences. That later, Bob could use as a primers and template of DNA polymerases to elongate those oligomers to a long DNA repeating DNA, synthetic DNA, like you mentioned this morning. And today my talk is somewhat related to the synthesis also. This is linker, which we can put it on oligonucleotide. So the first part I would like to explain property of novel amino linkers. The amino group of hexylamine, the reactivity is not satisfactory. So we have been trying to improve this amino group reactivity to derivatize by adding various lengths compound, carbamoyl, and then finally we found this shortest ethyl amino derivative is the choice. So we call this very short non-substituted SSH linker. And the second part probably I talk about the application of this type of oligonucleotides. So amino oligonucleotide are very useful material which we can use to immobilize oligomers to microarrays or microbeads, and this also can be derivatized to useful material. We can put the flow or biotin to oligonucleotide. So hexyl amino, we call this conventional C6, can be derivatized by substituting naphthyl or methoxy methyl, but finally we found this non-substituted H, we call H, this ethyl amino ethoxy carbamoyl has many advantages over this substituted one. So this oligomer, this linker, phosphoramidite, was synthesized from ethyl amine by introducing monomethoxytriethyl. This is reacted with carbonyl imidazole to the hexyl amino ethanol, and then converted to the Crothers amidite reagent. So this monomethyl group is very useful to purify the oligonucleotide by reverse phase column chromatography because of this idle obesity. So we could put it on reverse phase column and reacted non-triacylated materials were washed, and then we can remove monomethyl triacyl groups and with 3-fluoroacetic acid, a very short time. And then finally we could elute the product from the column. In aqueous solution, the very dilute acid was enough, but on the column we needed a stronger acid. So this procedures are very suitable for high throughput purification of oligonucleotide. So as I told, this SSH is the choice. Although the substituted linkers had better coupling properties with this fluoro, but in this case, SSH seemed satisfactory, but propio wasn't so reactive. But those are more reactive than the hexyl amino control. So the pKa body was measured, and this SSH is not low compared to naphthyl, but naphthyl substitution has some danger of acyl migration considered from the modeling of this anti-conformation. So, and also this compound, free amino compound, was quite unstable in ammonia treatment. So we have to remove acyl groups of oligonucleotide before the triacylation. So this type of linker has high reactivity, and also that non-methoxytriacyl group on this place can be removed very easily. So this is so now if we have naphthyl here, that has a chiral carbon in here. But if we have hydrogen here, it's rather simple and cost effective and stable. So this type of linker has been applied to DNA chicks, like yeast oligo chip or human pathway chip. So the next for the conjugation of this amino terminal. So 15 oligonucleotide or cholesterol oligonucleotide have been reported as advantageous properties for promoting hybridization or cellular uptakes. So here we would like to derivatize this type of oligonucleotide with amino acids or cholesterol derivatives. So first we remove monomethoxy trityl group with trichloroacetic acid and hexylenker was not so easy to remove. The amino dimethoxytrityl from here is not so easy. But here it's quite satisfactory in 30 seconds. Then in this case, I tested M-protected phenylalanine to this amino group. So coupling with oligosiderate, this reaction with protected phenylalanine active ester, this reaction went rather satisfactory, but slightly better than hexyl amino compound. But in the case of oligonucleotide with acyl protected sequences, their main product was acylated oligos. And so in this may be occurred during the DNA synthesis. So when we omit this diethylamine treatment, then we could obtain satisfactory yield, this compound, phenylalanine derivative. So with cholesterol chlorohomate, the coupling also went all right. So in this case, this linker was slightly more reactive than the hexyl control. So with oligonucleotide with containing various bases, in this case the yield wasn't so good. But when we use Daini Seiwa no Kyojin as a catalyst, we could improve the yield to 74%. So this reaction was applied to RNA derivatives. So RNA linked RNA, this monomethoxy trichlor was removed with trichloroacetic acid, and then coupled with cholesterol chloroformate in the presence of diethylamine and dimethylaminopyridine. And then the product was purified by reverse phase column. So the unreacted materials can be removed, and then the desired product was created after that. So in summary, the monomethoxy trichlor group on SSH modified oligonucleotide can be removed in mild acidic conditions more easily compared with other commercially available amino linkers. So SSH modified oligonucleotides prepared using commercially available SSH linker phosphoamidite can be rapidly purified from crude product with a reverse phase cartridge current. So this is very suitable for high throughput synthesis. So and also this linked oligonucleotide showed efficient reactivity with active esters of amino acid or cholesterol chloroformate on CPG support. And the yield was also better than the conventional 6 amino modified oligonucleotide. And so this SSH linker amidite was now commercially available. So the Advanced Institute Science and Technology licensed this linker to Sigma Aldrich in 2007. And the final slide, the people in the institute, mainly Dr. Komatsu, achieved this chemistry together with Dr. Kojima and other three assistants. Thank you very much.